Made with 98% ingredients from natural origins such as wild chamomile, the Zigo Difu Flawless Foundation by Yves Rocher is not only supposed to smooth your pores, but also give 24 hours of hydration and wear. Hi, my name is Muniza and I make beauty-related videos just like this one. So if this is your first time on my channel, consider subscribing and come be a part of the SaaS fam. Out of the 30 shades that this foundation comes in, I got the shade Beige 200. And in terms of consistency, it is not too thick or too runny, if that makes any sense. This foundation claims to smooth pores, so I'll apply a small amount on this side of my face without any primer, and you can blend the foundation with either your fingers, a foundation brush, or a damp beauty sponge. And this is one layer of the foundation without any primer and nothing on this side. Going in with my tea tree pore minimizer primer on this side before applying the foundation. And this is what the foundation looks like after the primer and before the primer. It seems to instantly dry down to a powder-like finish. And as I mentioned in my first impressions video, one layer gives medium coverage. It evened out my skin tone and blurred my pores by I'd say like 40 to 50%. And I'm just starting to notice it creasing ever so slightly under both my eyes. They do say it has adjustable coverage, which just means that it is a buildable foundation. And this is what two layers look like versus just one layer of the foundation. Let's quickly apply another layer on this side as well. And this is two layers after the primer and before the primer. Two thin layers of the foundation not only gives full coverage with a matte finish, but it also feels hydrating and lightweight because I don't even feel like I have foundation on my face right now. Unfortunately though, the creasing has gotten worse under both my eyes, so I do have to set it and hopefully it'll last 24 hours like they say it will. Checking in after 2 hours of applying the Zigo Difu Edulee Water Shot Flawless Foundation, and I gotta say I love how lightweight it feels on my skin. And then if you look up close, you'll see there is no caking or creasing after I set my under eye area. 12 hours later, the foundation from afar honestly is giving me airbrushed vibes. It doesn't feel tacky or oily to the touch, and it still has a matte finish even though it may not look like that with all the lights on right now. And then if you look up close, you can see that there's still no caking or creasing anywhere. My final thoughts on the Yves Rocher Zigo Difu Edulee Water Shot Flawless Foundation is that for $35 Canadian plus tax, I'd say it's worth it. And in terms of ratings, I'll give it 4 out of 5 stars only because it does crease under your eyes, so you do need to set it. And if you have some large pores like I do, you do need to use a primer as well. But all in all, I really do love the foundation and I can't recommend it enough because even after 12 hours, my makeup looks fresh, feels lightweight and hydrating. Unfortunately though, it does transfer quite a bit onto the mask. But instead of leaving my makeup looking patchy, it helps the foundation buff out to give my skin an airbrushed look. Now another foundation that I highly recommend that also gives an airbrushed look is the KVD Beauty Good Apple Skin Perfecting Foundation Balm, and you can click right here to watch that video, or if you want to watch any of my other videos, you can click right here and I'll see you there. Also, don't forget to smash the like button and subscribe to come be a part of the SaaS fam.